station, and I know you've been waiting for it all morning. We have recording artist Kalan Porter here with us now.
Hey.
Kalan, thanks for swinging by.
Oh, thanks for having me.
You've already had a bit of a busy morning.
Yeah, we had a live radio performance at 6:30, so it was pretty crazy.
What's it like getting up that early and having to sing? I mean, goodness.
Yeah, we definitely, you know, I didn't sing some of the high notes, so.
I cheated a little bit. Now, I do have to say, my girlfriend, I was just telling John earlier, my girlfriend over at Clear FM, Billy Joe, she just did an interview with him not too long ago and sent me an email. He's so cute and he smells so good, so what are you wearing? What is this that we're smelling?
It's cologne. It's called Lacoste.
Lacoste, okay.
There you go.
Anyway, so, I mean, you've gone through the whole junket now. It's been a couple of years since you won the title as Canadian Idol.
Yeah.
What's been going on since then? I mean,
I put out the first album and toured for about a year, and we did a 65 show tour. And then as soon as I did that, I got right back into the studio and started working on this new record. And then I found out that my mom was diagnosed with cancer, and it kind of shook my whole world. And so I ended up taking some time off and going home, and it was really important for me that I do that. And so I was kind of there while mom was going through her chemo and all that kind of stuff. So.
Now, I mean, going through an experience like that, does it show up in your writing, in your recordings of the next songs and stuff?
Yeah, it actually, you know, as negative of a time as it was, it did give me a whole new creative place to draw from. And so a lot of the new album really comes from what I was going through at the time. And I wrote, you know, most of the songs while mom was sick. There's a few songs that I wrote just weeks after she was diagnosed, and then some when she was doing better, because she's doing better now. So
That's great to hear.
So yeah, the record really spans the full spectrum, definitely.
And you also kind of took that experience and really put it to a lot of good. You were working with the Run for the Cure.
Yeah, I did the 5K run the other day, and I was you know, very on board to do it and help out, and I wanted to, you know, give back. And then I found out you actually have to run, and so.
Oh.
But it was great. And I think, you know, there was a Team Kalan across the country, and I think we raised $60,000 or something like that.
Well, that's incredible. And you also contributed some music, did you not?
Yeah, I sang the anthem and stuff like that. And, you know, I don't know all the statistics and the latest research and that kind of thing, but I do know how much the work of that foundation has helped my family and families across Canada. So if I can give back in a small way, that would be great.
And, I mean, you certainly did, which is a great thing. Now, tell us a little bit about this CD coming up. You co-wrote a lot of the songs, said that a lot of it was coming from the experience. So how long did it take you to put this one together?
Well, this album was completely different than the first one. The first one was made very quickly and kind of was what it needed to be. And Canadian Idol gives you the opportunity to get to a lot of people very quickly. But now it was up to me to kind of go back and really prove myself and earn credibility over time, kind of thing. So I went down and I recorded in LA over about 6 months, and it was great. I loved LA and recorded with Brian Maloof, who's worked with everybody from Madonna to Michael Jackson to Pearl Jam. So some really, you know,
big names.
Yeah, cool, yeah. People working on the record. So.
And I'm curious, are you still fiddling?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm actually we're playing a show tonight at the Garrick Theatre, and I'm doing a lot of electric violin and that kind of thing. And the band that I've got with me too is really great. We're having a lot of fun. So.
Great. Now, you just said that you put together the first album very quickly, and it was what it needed to be for the Canadian Idol. How do you feel about that title? I mean, are you still happy to be affiliated with that? Or are you trying to break away from that a little bit?
You know, it's a bit of a double-edged sword, definitely. You know, I obviously would not have this opportunity without that, and it does give such an amazing opportunity to people trying to get into the industry. But at the same time, now I do want to move past that and become an artist in my own right, and that's kind of, you know, what I'm trying to do. And so I went back, and I think this new album is a lot more me and kind of what I want to be doing. So.
And when you say it's a lot more you, how would you describe it? What would you? What's a lot more you? What are you trying to be now?
I don't know exactly. I think that album is a little darker and moodier than I'd initially expected, just because of the stuff I was going through.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess you can only write about kind of what you're going through at the time. But, you know, I'm not really sure, you know, how I would define myself. It's definitely, you know, pop music, but I hope that, you know, I can, you know, the songs that I'm writing and that kind of thing are you know, not quite as, you know, generic as some of the stuff, so.
Okay, well, you've got a show coming up. This is happening at the Garrick Center?
Yeah, we're playing tonight, and like I said, we've been rehearsing the heck out of the show, and it's a lot of fun. It's kind of one of the smaller intimate venues that we're doing, and so I think it'll be a really fun show.
Great, and the new CD is in stores right now, August 28th it came out, so it's still pretty new, and I mean, it's been doing great so far.
Yeah, it's been pretty overwhelming. I didn't know if taking time off and going home would, you know, how it would be, but the fans are great. So
they waited for you.
Yeah, it's exciting to be back. So.
And we're going to wait for you to sing. You're going to be doing that a little bit later in the show for us, too.
For sure,
so
yeah.
Thank you so much for sticking around, and we'll be hearing from Kalan Porter a little later on. We do need to take a break right now, so we'll be back.